turning off the roundabout in the main street of Moruya, we headed on Araluen Rd towards Braidwood, which was an 80 kilometre journey. The first almost 10 kilometres of the Araluen Rd is sealed, and some of it is fairly recently sealed.
There's nothing left inside of here.
When you first start on the dirt here on Araluen Rd, it's freshly graded and very wide, and you can see that they've actually put in a lot of work on this road. Kind driver pulls over to the left. The road reminds me quite a bit of the Bridal Track. It's been a few years since it's been closed. It actually opened in May this year, and even though it's open, it's still closed on Mondays to Saturdays from 8:30 till 3:30, so you have to ride it on a Sunday by and large. We were really surprised about how good this surface actually is, and the more you ride it, the more work that you can see they've actually put into it. Sealing some small sections and doing a lot of support for the road where it drops off the edges of the cliff. This is another example where the Yoruba Dala Shire Council's actually put a heap of work into the refurbing or the restoring of the road. It's 56 kilometres to Araluen, and other than these bitumen fixes along the way, it's still dirt all the way to Araluen. Every now and then the road opens up a bit, crosses a bridge or so, and passes by some properties. It's really a great ride. It's wide in some sections, narrow in others, super smooth, and then this is the only bit of not super smooth section on the whole road, and that doesn't go for very long at all. Just like the Bridle Track, Araluen Rd had part of the road wash away, and instead of fixing that section, they created a bypass and cut that bypass further into the mountain as well. Unlike the Bridle Track, which has heaps of camping areas, Araluen Rd has the Deua River and the Baker's Flat camping areas, both known as two-wheel drive accessible. We love riding the King's Highway, but this really is the relaxing route from Moruya to Braidwood. But still, we really enjoyed this ride. It's great riding towards the mountains and sometimes hugging the cliff's edges around the bends, and certainly plenty of scenic views along the way. You see the road closed sign here on the left. That's obviously left there from the Monday to Saturday work and should have been covered over for the Sunday. But yeah, the work they're doing on this road is truly amazing, and they've done a lot of grading to make it so smooth. But look at the reinforcements as well as you go along this Deua River. See some basic gravel base along the road here, a new safety rail, and the road is narrower as well, so it must be safer for the drivers going in each direction. As you near Araluen, the Queanbeyan Palarang Regional Council start doing the road maintenance, and they're doing a little bit of work on the road as well. Now all this maintenance is meant to finish by the end of October, so in November the road's supposed to be open 7 days a week. As you wind closer to the Western Mountains Valley, you're nearing the small township of Araluen, which was once a thriving haven. The sealed mountain climb out of Araluen towards Braidwood is in the best condition we've seen it, despite the fact that it's still got some traffic control lights on it. It's amazing to think in the late 1800s that Araluen had over 20 hotels and was one of the richest goldfields in Australia, all on the sign.
But